Portable 3-screen monitor, one cable for dual display. It's right now, that's the box, that's how it arrived. Now we are going to open it and find out what's included with this equipment and also how to connect it to my computer, to my laptop, because it's on purpose for laptop. Turn your laptop into three display instead of just one. Perfect for working. It's right now, let's open the box. And before to even open the box, look at that, included in the package was this nice soft case, transportation slash storage case for the extended monitor system. So that's a nice touch that actually I was not expecting. Big reveal time. And hop, it's all white, yeah! Actually, it has some nice foam to protect everything. And that's the real reveal time. And right away, we do have instruction for MacBook, driver installation and display setting, and on the back here for Windows. So either MacBook or Windows laptop works perfectly just following those instructions right there with picture, so easy to follow. And about easy to follow, we have some instructions how to connect the monitor here. Again, very nicely illustrated, so you cannot mess up the connection. And now we are at the gear level. That's the nice, it looks very nice actually. I like the look and the feel. The very nice extended monitor system. And here they are, all folded up. Will fit actually nicely into this soft pouch, soft case that I showed you earlier. So that's great. Let's put that on the side for now. There is an accessory up compartment here, where we do have the driver on the USB stick, and it's not a crappy USB stick even. It's a very nice metal USB stick that has USB-C on one side and normal USB on the other side. It says driver on it. The USB key capacity is 4 giga. And then we have connecting cable with two normal USB to USB-C. So you can connect that to your normal USB on your computer, and that's to the monitor. And then we have some plastic protective cap here. It's apparently, it helps to reduce the shaking if your laptop screen thickness is less than 6 mm. And another cable, straightforward USB-C to USB-C. If your laptop have USB-C, you can just directly use this cable instead of this other cable right here. And of course, the user manual. And that's all for the box. Now let's have a look at those monitors by themselves, see how they look like before installation. So here we do have a plastic to peel out with some important instruction about the connection right in the front. So that's monitor one. Monitor two, it's on the other side. It's folded up right now. And here we do have some button to control, plus and minus button on two sides, plus and minus for one monitor and plus and minus for the second monitor. So each monitor have its plus and minus button separately. Here we go, we unfold the monitor like so. So number one here and number two here. So here we go. Once it's completely unfolded, it goes out of my photo table here. But here we go, it's quite big, so which is good. Quite decent size monitor on each side here. And that will be the area where I can install my laptop. And here are the USB ports, USB-C ports on the monitor system. Here where you have to connect your laptop to. So right here, we have one that have a power logo and one have the data logo, USB data logo here. So two USB-C ports. And here we go. Everything is installed on my ThinkPad laptop. It is 15 inches and the installation went perfectly. You do not want to have a very thick screen though, because those little flange here, little plastic bits, have to go above the screen as shown here. So if you have a too thick screen, those will not fit properly. As well as this corner here, have to go around your screen and this corner here as well. That way the whole setup will be secure and will not slide away or whatever if you move a little bit your laptop screen. As for the installation, it's very easy. To be able to match your laptop screen, this unit over there will expand or retract. That way you can make it match your laptop screen without any issue. There is no lock mechanism that I can find though, so it just sit there and match your laptop screen and can be easily open again at any time without pressing any lock mechanism, pressing any button. There is also in the back of the screen a little fit that you can remove. It's magnetic, so you can just pull it out like so. And then there is a button that you can press to adjust the length of this fit. That way it will support your screen, all those three screens that are a little bit heavy, especially on your laptop, on your own laptop screen, can put some weight on it. So you may want to use this little foot in the back to support some of this weight. Now, as for the connection, well, if you have a USB-C equipped laptop like mine right there, it's easy. You just have to use the USB-C to USB-C cable. You plug it here on your USB-C port on your laptop and then in the back on the USB-C port of the extra monitor system. If you do not have a USB 3 port on your laptop, see if your laptop is a little bit older, don't worry, they talk about it as well. You may use this other cable that has two USB plug along with the USB-C plug that you still have to connect behind those extra extended monitor. But then you can connect the USB connector in your computer if you have two free USB connector, or if you have only one USB connector, they even talk about that. You can connect the power, which is the red one, so you connect the power one to a block, to a power block, your phone, your tablet, etc., and to a regular outlet. So you connect the red one to any power, 5-volt power, or directly in your computer, and then you can make the screen work with the older model of laptop that does not have USB-C like this one. Anyway, time to install the driver and then run everything. Let's go. Right away at boot, all the screen turn on, which is great. So I just plugged my driver USB key in my computer and now I'm going to install the driver on Windows. So I'm going to show you a quick step-by-step installation of the driver on Windows. If you have Apple, there are other instructions on the key itself, a little video that will also help you to install those driver on your Apple machine. There you have it, here we go. After installing the driver and rebooting my computer, I have those two other screens, two extra screens, that means three screens now on my laptop, which looks very good. And of course, if you want to adjust the brightness of each independent screen, here are the buttons. You have a plus and minus on each side, so plus and minus for this screen and plus and minus here for this one. So you can just press plus if you want plus brightness and minus if you want minus brightness, up to you, and that works for both monitor. And that's it. Here you go, guys. Those looks awesome, and I'm sure you will enjoy your system as I'm enjoying mine already. In any case, thanks for watching. Hope this video has been useful. That's a great product, and see you next time. Bye bye.